हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इंडियाज आंसर टू चाइना बैक्ड थाई कैनाल प्लान। थाई कैनाल द सॉल्यूशन टू मलाका प्रॉब्लम। द 120 किलोमीटर्स लॉन्ग थाई कैनाल इज एन इंटीग्रल पार्ट ऑफ चाइनाज मैरिटाइम सिल्क रोड इनिशिएटिव विच इन इटसेल्फ इज द की कंस्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ द एम्बिशियस वन बेल्ट वन रोड प्रोजेक्ट। The Kara Canal is China's attempt at solving its Malacca problem. The Malacca Strait is one of the busiest routes with reportedly 84,000 ships passing through it every year, carrying around 30% of global sea trade. It connects the Pacific Ocean with the Indian Ocean. By building of the Kara Canal, China will be able to bypass the Malacca Strait, cutting both time and distance. China will be one of the biggest beneficiaries of the Thai Canal project, that is Kara Canal. That will give Beijing an alternative route to the congested Malacca Strait. The Kara Canal will slice through Thailand is expected to alter the strategic calculus in the region and has nudged India to upgrade its infrastructure in its island. This channel would let ships bypass the choked Malacca Strait, the main shipping channel between the Indian Ocean and the Pacific Ocean that has become the world's busiest trade route. For ships passing between the Indian and Pacific Oceans, it would shorten the distance by at least 1200 kilometers. India is developing its maiden deep sea port in Indonesia's Sabang, close to Andaman and Nicobar Islands, making its maiden foray in the Southeast Asian amid China's slew of connectivity plans for Asian under BRI. The Sabang port is being developed in partnership with neighbor and strategic partner Indonesia. The deep sea port will give India wide access to Southeast Asia as a counterbalancing force. The port will be a key element in India's Indo-Pacific strategy. Military upgrades in islands. With Chinese Navy positioning itself for dominance in the Indian Ocean through strings of ports in Myanmar, Pakistan and Iran, India is planning rapid infrastructure upgrade in its island territories to ensure that there is no restriction on navigation or a replay of the South China Sea in Indian backyard. Lakshadweep sits on the 9-degree channel, so named because it lies on the 9-degree line of latitude north of the equator. The Andamans and Nicobar Islands will allow the Navy to dominate the 6-degree and 10-degree channels towards Southeast Asia and North Asia. Airports. Airstrips in Shippur, Campbell and Agati. According to top military officials, India will upgrade the airstrip at INS Kohasa, Shippur in North Andamans and at the Campbell Strip at Nicobar into full-fledged fighter bases. The airstrip at Agati in Lakshadweep will also be upgraded for military operations to secure both the Bay of Bengal up to Malacca Straits and Arabian Sea up to Gulf of Aden. The two island territories will be like the new aircraft carriers for India, extending the Navy reach in the region far from the mainland. Both the islands sit on the busiest sea lanes of the world, with more than half the world trade growing through this route. India's answer to China's backed Thai Canal plan. It is argued that the infrastructure upgrade in the island territories would serve two main objectives. 1. Enable India to maximize the economic gains as well as raise its military presence in the Indian Ocean region. The continuing focus on the infrastructure upgrade also comes against the backdrop of China's aggressive moves in Ladakh and its reluctance to restore status quo ante. The Chinese aggression has not only prompted New Delhi to reinforce force deployment along hotspots along the LSE but also in the high seas. The Indian Navy is on high alert from the Persian Gulf to the Malacca Strait in the context of the standoff with China. The instructions to the Navy are clear that they should be prepared for military action if China mounts an attack along the line of actual control. Thanks, and like my video and subscribe my channel for more updates.